About a week ago, Emma Watson, a very famous actress and feminist, spoke in front of the UN on behalf of a movement called He for She. In the speech, she outlined exactly why she was a feminist and why she thinks it's important for men to be feminists as well, and why it's important for men to join this new movement. For anyone who supports Emma Watson and the He for She movement, I address you here now. I appreciate that, for once, a feminist movement is finally trying to reach towards men and get them to speak out on issues of gender inequality. There may be a feminist agenda undercutting it that I may disagree with, but at least they're attempting to include us within the conversation. And that is more than I can say for the majority of feminists I have addressed here on YouTube. However, with this invitation for me as a heterosexual man to join this movement surrounding women's rights, I have to respectfully decline your offer. I decline this offer to join and fight for equal rights, as you put it, because I feel that taking a gendered approach towards these sorts of issues is not at all productive. And in fact, it can be counterproductive to the overall intended goal of equality. I certainly recognize that there are certain areas where women are disenfranchised compared to men, and vice versa. But if we were only to look at women suffering in that area, we first of all ignore the men who do so, as few in number as they may be. I think that it is injustice to men who suffer in traditionally women's issues, like sexual assault or rape. And second of all, it really does little to embrace society within addressing these problems. If we were to only label them as women's problems or men's problems, I think that it is counterproductive and it is unnecessary. These are problems with humanity. True, women may suffer more from a certain problem than men do. Men may suffer more from another problem compared to women. But as an egalitarian, I care about women and men equally. And I don't think that taking one side over these approaches is productive. Traditionally speaking, in many cultures, men have had a lot more power compared to women. We have had the right to vote. We have had the right to go certain places where women were not allowed. And the law treated us generally more favorably than it did to women. This is more true, especially in third world countries. People will have you believe that this is a result of a patriarchal structure, that our culture is inherently biased against women, and we inherently shun women's values and women's rights. But this is not true. We are not a culture that hates women. Rather, this is the role that was assigned to men. True, men have had all the power in the past, generally speaking, but we have also held most of the responsibilities. We had a responsibility to our families, to be the breadwinner. We've had the responsibility to go to work, to earn money for people that depend on us for survival. We've had all of the perks and the downsides of being the ones in charge. But make no mistake about it, it has not been easy for us. As for why men have traditionally held more power and responsibilities compared to women, in most cultures, I can't say. I don't have an exact answer for you. But what I will say is that simply by giving women power that they allegedly deserve, just for the sake of equality, will not, in fact, bring about equal rights for both men and women. For that to happen, women have to accept the burdens that are associated with power. They have to respect that with great power comes great responsibility. And men, conversely, while they will have to relinquish some of their power, it will also mean that if it were to be a truly equal society, they would also relinquish some of their burdens. Time and time again, I have heard feminists wax on and on about how women are disenfranchised and oppressed by this patriarchal system, and for movements like He for She that seek to restore balance by giving women the same rights that men have. And while I do agree that in the end, this must happen in order for true equality to be the result, what also needs to happen is that women have to accept the burdens associated with said power. And men should be able to relinquish some of those burdens in addition to their power and pass them on to women as equals. Thus far, I have yet to hear a single feminist address this. Many will scoff at what I've had to say so far and say, well, of course women are prepared to accept the burdens associated with power. But are they really? I've heard many feminists complain that they have not had the same opportunities for leadership and assertive positions. But what about positions where there is manual labor involved? What about positions that aren't paid very much? Positions that no one covets, yet need to be filled for society to be run? Like, how many feminists do you know advocate for jobs in waste disposal and septic treatment? Again, I'm not saying that women have less of a right or an entitlement to these positions as men. I'm not saying they don't deserve power and the same rights that men have. But what I am saying is that if they want true equality, then they better stick to that story and not meander away from that goal. And that is why I cannot agree with this He for She movement. It is because I don't think it stands for true equality. What it stands for is men raising awareness for women's rights. And while I think it is an admirable goal and something that probably should happen, I don't think that that by itself is the answer to equalizing all the wrongs that have been caused by society towards women. And as I've said before, I don't appreciate a gendered approach in an issue that has been plaguing society in general when they have yet to acknowledge really the other half of the story. And I think that until they do, until they acknowledge the man's side and they give all of the reasons why men should not have to hold the burdens that they do, I think that this movement will not bring about social progress in the way that it hopes to. Thank you for watching, and may the truth always be heard. Peace.